comedy and a little bit of storytelling, I guess, too. Anyway. So she was mildly annoyed with me at that point. Plus another person or two had opened the gifts and I did the same thing to them. You know. Of course. So she gets this big box. Big box, right? Like I said, I put like 5 or 6 boxes inside of it that you had to open each time. It's like a new present inside. So, she had gotten down to the very end of it, and I actually put a false bottom on it, right? Because again, it was something small, I don't know, it's like a necklace or a pair of nice earrings or, I don't know, something small, you know? And she had got down to the bottom and I put a false bottom on it, and so it just had a note in it that said, "From Santa Claus, you've been very naughty this year. You've been very mean to your brother recently, so you're on the naughty list this time around." And then I took a rock, a small rock that I found in our garden, and I painted it black and just stippled a little bit of like a dark gray color on it. So I made it look like a piece of gold. So I said she was on her naughty list. And, so Santa was just giving her a lump of coal this year. surprise and anger. She just ended up knocking me straight on the head. You know, my parents are all concerned because I'm like, for a second, you know. The real kicker, people. There was a false bottom, so I told her after the fact, or once I had recovered, the chaos had, you know, waned, and my parents stopped freaking out as much, and yada yada, right? So, I said, hey, there's a false bottom. If you open it up here, there's another box. And she's like, I swear to God, if you're lying to me again, I'm gonna throw the rock at your head again. Well, I was not lying. There was actually a nice gift in there. And she's like, oh my God, I feel bad. I actually really like it. You did a really good job, yada yada. But I'm still not sorry for throwing a rock at your head. Not to put rocks in people's bags because there's a chance they might get thrown at your head. So anyway, listen to me. No, like, me, my sister, my mom and dad are the only ones in my family that live in this state. The others live in a nearby state. And because of, you know, the state of the world, we will leave it at that. We ain't really gone and visit them, you know? They didn't really come to see us. You know, we were a little bit, well, most of us, generally speaking, were more on the cautious side of things, not to get political, you know, with the current state of affairs and things floating around in the universe. So we didn't really go out and, like, visit my family that much for a while, you know, so I haven't really seen my family in at least 2 years now at this point. So we were all kind of waiting at least for a vaccine or something to, you know, so that we would all at least feel comfortable. We all have different opinions on that. I'm not going to get into it, but, you know, it was generally agreed upon that family was only going to get together once we were all vaccinated and stuff, so, here we are. So my grandpa's coming to visit. He's going to be here for, I don't know, almost 2 weeks, like a week and a half, let's say. Seen my sister's house either, so that's gonna be pretty cool too. So it's also my youngest nephew's first ever Christmas. He's not even a year old, so. Inside of boxes, like a jokester about it with my family, but that's not gonna fly for them. So I'm nice and respectful, and I make nice gifts for them. In theory, I try. So I am going to turn this. Best niece ever from Uncle Nathan. I don't actually have any bows right now. So otherwise I would be putting bows on these. Oops. Okay, so what now? What now? What now? This I don't mind showing on camera either, because I can promise you my dogs do not watch my YouTube channel. So I think I have some control over that. Actually, my parents don't even know that I have a YouTube channel. This is actually for my parents' dogs, and I know they don't even know, so, you know, this video is going to be released a couple days before Christmas. I highly doubt my parents are going to find my YouTube channel and show it to my dogs. You know, I don't mind them finding out, even if they do find out about my YouTube channel. You know, so, it doesn't really matter too much as far as a gift to my dogs go. Now this is not going to work. bastard. As always. Wrong tape. I know this is not probably the most exciting video in the world, but hey, it's Christmas, and I told myself I would do at least one. Songs. Some of them are so old, they've been around, you know, hundreds of years. I'm not really worried about copyright on some like super old Silent Night song or something from the year 1500, you know, I don't know. But what if, like, I don't know, make some Michael Blue Blade reference, or I don't know, some Bing Crosby or something, and next thing you know, no, you're copyrighted, oh no, now it's the end of the world. So I'm just trying to avoid that and spare you from my horrible singing. You made it this far. You're a champion, and I highly appreciate you, because I know this is not the most trigger-laced video, but hopefully you enjoy the cutting sounds and the sounds from the tape. that's gonna be it for the year. I got a couple more to do, and I'm just gonna focus on bow, throw, bow, walk, and then bow. Blow through those ones. I'm gonna focus on and blow through this one. So just leave me like comments, Bradley. Leave me like comments, Rad. Let me know if you have any fun Christmas stories or have anything particularly fun that you have planned this Christmas or holidays. You know, if you don't actually celebrate Christmas. See ya.